Hi, I'm Alex Carella. I'm the product manager for the environmental suite of TestLab, dynamic environmental testing solution of LMS TestLab. And I'm here at KUL, at the Catholic University of Leuven in Belgium, to find out a bit more about multiple input and multiple output vibration testing, or MIMO testing.
Some years ago, we decided as a research group in dynamics and acoustics to invest in a cube shaker table. The vision behind that was that typically in university lab conditions, you don't reach the operational load levels and frequency ranges that are typically encountered in real life. And we decided to go for this test rig because it allows us to do multi-axial testing in combination with non-linear identification. That is typically a tough regime to investigate. That's typically what university labs try to avoid and stick to the low level conditions. But we had the vision that we wanted to go for the real life operational conditions. So we have three missions, so to speak. We have education, research, and consultancy to industry. We are still the only university lab in the world that has such a cube.
The cube is a 6 degrees of freedom high frequency hydraulic shaker. It has a frequency range from 3 up to 300 Hertz. As I said, it's a 6 degrees of freedom system, which means that we can control multiple axes simultaneously. It has a maximum stroke in the vertical direction of 100 millimeters and 50 millimeters in the planar direction. We use the cube for either for consulting for external companies, also for internal research projects. According to the signal we receive, if we receive a signal in time domain, then we use LMS TWR software. Instead, if we receive power spectra in frequency domain, we can use the new LMS MIMO random control. We control it multiple axes in order to shrink a bit the time consumed for the testing, and also to recreate a more realistic situation.
The cube is a very interesting multi-axial device thanks to its compact hydraulic design. Key to the usage of such a device is to make sure that each of the six axes can be controlled in a repeatable and independent manner. And this calls for very advanced control schemes because the risk of crosstalk between the six degrees of freedom is an item. And together with our spin-off company LMS, we are developing advanced controller schemes to optimally steer the 6 degrees of freedom in an independent and controllable manner. And this not only calls for unique infrastructure, but on top of that, we need advanced controller schemes to make sure that eventually the cube can replicate what a typical road test, for instance, would tell you when you go to a proving ground.